Hey, Mr. Mosquitoes, and we're back. So Winston feeling towards his father, Steve Harvey. How does he truly feel about his dad? Welcome back to MacIndoe 7 Run Unfiltered Terror. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and say a prayer. Get what I'm saying? So, a few people put in the comment section that they want to know how Winston truly felt towards Steve Harvey. I think that now that I think as an adult, he probably let shit go, but I don't know. Everything's videos alleged. Winston, how you feel about your daddy? And Winston, you're quite handsome. How you feel about your daddy? Judgment. He feel judged by him all the time. Reflection, inner calling, being forgiveness, awareness, awakening. So he feel like his father is super judgmental. And critical of who he is, and he's judgmental. But he is, though. He's like that with every fucking body. At the bottom, we got the Nine of Swords. This is a nine, right? I'm doing good. So, yeah, nine in reverse. The Nine of Swords in reverse. You have to let go of the anxiety and release the worry. But like I said before, I think that he has gained clarity now that he is older. But, I think that he'll always feel judgment from his father and what he does and critical of the things that he says and how he says them and how he does them. The things that all parents just want you to be the best to your ability. However, for me, I think my personal opinion is that his expectations are unrealistic. Steve Harvey, he has unrealistic opinions, but I don't really want to listen to too much of anything of what someone has to say that doesn't have integrity. And he does not have integrity, Winston. And I believe that you did. And I feel like that's where you struggle. I feel like you struggle with your father's opinions and judging you because you do things that are right. Right for people, right from your heart. And I don't think that he understands that because he doesn't have integrity. He doesn't have humility. He doesn't thrive off of principle. He worships the dollar bill where you may worship God, or you may feel like truth is the way, where he feel like, no, the money is the way. You get what I'm saying? So I think that that is where the judgment comes into play now, opposed to him feeling judged or feeling left out as a child. I feel like it has now just switched to a different type of judgment. Even with the Nine of Swords at the bottom, that lets me know that he has been working on himself and letting go some of the anxieties and issues that he does have towards his dad as he has grown up. I'm assuming that's through therapy or something, which is good. And gaining clarity and facing his own fears and understanding that he is who he's supposed to be and he has to live right within himself and be the man that he's supposed to be. Not necessarily the man that Steve Harvey wants him to be. So I completely get that, Winston. Come through, my nigga. Come through. Give me another card that represents how you feel about your dad. Justice in reverse. Prejudice, injustice, legal complications, dishonesty, failure to take responsibility, unfairness. Like I said before, Winston felt like he was treated a certain type of way when he was younger, and that was his feelings towards his father when he was younger. I literally just said that. Come through this bitch spirit way. We got death and a split. And then at the bottom, we got the King of Pentacles. So I feel like every dog has his day. And I feel like Winston feels like at the end of the day, I can't expect you to acknowledge what you've done. At the end of the day, God, you have to face God. And that's where your judgment will lie. And I think that Winston either is coming to that or has already come to that. Like death is the end of something, and he would have to deal with that during death. He doesn't wish death on his father. He wants the way that his father judgments comes at, he wished that would stop. But at the end of the day, we're all going to be judged, and his father, his father is guilty as fuck, and he knows that. So it's like, Dad, you got way more fish to fry when you go. I wish that you end the cycle with me now, and that'll help you when you do go. Winston seemed like he's a little bit more grounded, and he's a little bit more spiritually tapped in. And I also had the King of Pentacles. I feel like that's what tangled in with the death card. Like, it comes to a death to every king, every dog will have his day. There is someone that you must answer to when you die. The you worshiping money is not is not even good. And I wouldn't be surprised if this was part of their conversations, personal conversations, about how he worships money, how his son may feel the complete opposite about money. He may live off of his integrity, which I'm going for. I live off my principles and my morals and my integrity. I'm not jeopardizing that shit for nobody. Your father, he don't give a fuck. He won't do whatever the money lead him, whatever the devil tell him to do. That's what he down to do. And it's like he want to get Winston on that bandwagon, but Winston ain't really fucking with that. You know what I mean? He feel like Def need to, allegedly, he feel like Def need to come to his father in that regard. But we all have to face the music at some point. Spirit, come through this bitch. Ah, yes, you gave me the last call. I didn't even answer that bitch. It fell right out. So we got the Queen of Swords, and I feel like that is Defrey Marjorie. And we have the Hierophant. I mean, we have the High Priestess in reverse. We had nothing but high cards, arcana cards. I feel like Winston has a very good grounded wisdom, spirituality, guidance, and is going on the right path. Lack of self-trust, out of reach, out of touch, out of balance, accepting surface knowledge. Man, materialistic things is literally surface, accepting surface knowledge is pretty much man material, giving things money, fame, and shit like that, if you didn't know. And this is what the Queen of Swords, which was with Mordred, she worships that as well. Come through, Winston. Come through. Independent, supportive, honest, unbiased judgment. And we know that she ain't honest. She's definitely supportive because she gonna go wherever the bed go. Clear boundaries and insightful. So, like I said before, his mother rules, Wishacom rules with an iron fist. And I mentioned that before, that she's really the king pin around this bitch. I said that earlier, and he even acknowledged the fact that she's the queen pin around this bitch. Come through, Spirit. And the High Priestess. All right, now. Come on, card. Acting like you don't want to come over here. Ooh, Winston, how you feel about your deity and your stepmother? I ain't even asked about the bitch. She came out with a sword. What? Came in here trying to fight me. Come through, Winston. Sorry. Winston feels sorry for y'all. And I would too, soulmate. He feels sorry for you too, bitch. He feels sorry for both our Marjorie and Steve. But again, I feel like it's because they worship materialistic things, which I completely get. Divine part, and I just say he was talking about Marjorie. Insecure she is. if you snatched all of the money and riches from her, oh, this bitch would be insecure as fuck. Oh my goodness, because she really not that. Like, money makes people cute. Let's be clear. So. You could be a regular bitch and not be all that cute, but when you get some bread, bitch, you look way better. So, to me, Marjorie in a regular bitch, she not all that. Like, as a regular girl, she's really not. Like, she need bread to make her look the way that she look. Me look, we got no contact, liar, confusion, silent. She be lying, single. Listen. You be lying and shit. Both of y'all lies, telling people that y'all, well, y'all act like y'all single. Both of y'all confused as fuck. Both of y'all lies, and both of y'all be having no contact. So sometimes I don't think that Winston has contact with y'all because of the confusion and the sorcery that y'all are in the midst of and a part of. I don't think Winston with shit like that. Like, I'm seeing a different type of, like, energy from him. You know how Solange ain't fucking with Beyonce and them? That's what he's giving me a little bit. I'm loving it. Addictions. Y'all got some addictions? Competition. Y'all be in competition with each other? Game over. Cheetah in the split. Married right under Cheetah. Ego. That's his daddy. Game about to be over. The cheating ego. And you married, come on, Spirit, come through this bitch. Let's see what's in these hidden hearts. What's in the hidden hearts? How you really feel about your deity? How you really feel about your deity? Tell me how you really feel about your deity.
Shit.
Chemistry in reverse. He don't feel like he and his father has a chemistry that they should have as father and son. We got pride. The pride gets in the way. Arrogance, ego, and that's the second time ego done came the fuck out. Remembers right here. Look, money is right under ego. Like, all his father cared about is money, and his and Winston ain't fucking with shit like that. Curse, hex, witchcraft. That's how he feel about Marjorie with the high priestess shit. He feel like she practiced. She be doing some shit she ain't got no business doing. We got karma. Consequences, cause and effect, debts. And I've been talking about his father paying his debt and consequences of his father. I'm stuttering. Consequences of his deity. I believe these are things that he has said to his father. I'm not going to go to the crime deck on him because I don't think that Winston knows a whole lot of that. But Winston, I'm going to give you some oracle messages, though. Because you need strength. I feel like you in a house full of snakes, my nigga. Like, that's how I feel. We got two of them popped out. Let me turn the deck over. Let me see what's at the bottom. Remember that you can change. That you can't change anyone. I said you in a house full of snakes, didn't I? You can't change none of them bitches. You got to go. Be by yourself and be yourself. Speak up and speak out. Let your voice be heard loud and clear. No one said this whole life was a race. It's okay to slow down. So, it's okay not to compete. Don't compete with them. No matter how you try to cut it, slice it, dice it, and ABC it to them in a nursery rhyme of how the integrity should lie there, how the love of God should overpower the love of money. Winston, you are in a losing spiritual battle, my nigga. You have lost this battle. You have lost this battle. We will win the war because I'm on the same pathway that you on. We will win the war, but these surface thinking motherfuckers, I forget which cause said surface worship, basically, surface knowledge, surface material shit. We way deeper than that, baby. I got goosebumps crazy. Winston, my hats is off to you because I believe that you are maneuvering in a very tight space where you can be manipulated and you are keeping solid, and I'm down with that. So I'm definitely going to pray for you, Winston. I'm going to pray that you just exit out the situation unscathed completely, because everybody over there, they going exactly where the fuck you told them they were going to go if they didn't change, because you told them that. I feel it. And this is the reading, y'all. This was powerful as fuck. I know it's only 12 minutes, but this was, I got goosebumps all over right now. Thank y'all for tuning in to MacInDow 7 Runner for Tarot. If I feel like it a little bit later, I might do some more readings because it's early, but I also might go get my nails done, so I don't know. But I love y'all to light. Y'all have a great Sunday. What was I about to say? Drink plenty of water. Don't forget to feed people that can't feed themselves. Pray for your neighbor. I'm sorry, y'all. I'm having like a brain fart or something. But make sure that you're treating people how you want them to be treated. That's the biggest thing. So I love y'all to light. Y'all enjoy the rest of this weekend. It's sunny outside. Get some fresh air. And I'm out this bitch. Peace.